Fossil fuel remains as the major source of energy in this era. Do you know what is the smallest burning fossil fuel? It's natural gas. It is small and it is clean. It emits 60% less carbon dioxide as compared to coal. Natural gas, as suggested by its name, occurs in gaseous form under ambient condition, or it may be liquefied into liquefied natural gas under extremely low temperature. Has it ever occurred to you that these small molecules may also exist in a solid form within a structure that looks just like ice? This ice-like compound, which comprises of natural gas and water, are named natural gas hydrates. They are found naturally in the permafrost and also in the continental margin. And guess what? The amount of carbon that is sequestered in hydrate form is more than twice of all the conventional energy combined. While it can be seen as a major source of energy, it is also a potential threat to the environment. Just imagine a case of the melting of these hydrates, releasing huge amount of natural gas to the atmosphere. Therefore, it is important for us to understand what is going on with the naturally occurring hydrates. And in order to do that, we'll have to first retrieve a representative hydrate sample. While hydrate samples may be retrieved from their naturally occurring locations, the operation is costly, and even worse, it will cause disturbance to the natural properties of these hydrates. So this is where my PhD project comes into the picture. In my project, I seek to understand how hydrates are formed under conditions that are similar to those in the nature, for example, in the presence of salt and in the presence of different sands. Once we have the fundamental understanding on how hydrates are formed under these conditions, we then selected a selection of conditions which allow us to form methane hydrates within the order of weeks, as opposed to those in nature, which takes millions of years to form. We have also characterized our laboratory formed hydrates according to their phase saturation, which is a commonly used metric during the reservoir characterization, allowing us to establish a link between the laboratory hydrates and those that are found in the nature. Once the link is made, we then study the gas and water production profile under different parameters, which allow us to look into the key elements that can significantly affect the stability of gas hydrates. We hope that with advancements towards the understanding of the naturally occurring hydrates, we will be able to extract energy from them before they are released and devastate our environment. With this, I thank you.